Hey guys, welcome to Parker Group Live on this beautiful Tuesday morning. One of the questions that we always get as we're working with folks buying and selling homes is, what's first? Should we buy a house before we sell our house, or should we sell our house first? And Rachel's going to kind of help you through that process today and explain the best case scenario in that situation.
So, unfortunately, there's no easy answer to whether it's best to sell your home first or buy your new home first, because a lot of it depends on your personal situation and whether the timing or the finance of everything is more important to you. So just some pros and cons of each approach so you can make an informed decision if your family's going through this right now. If you're considering buying your next house before you put your current house on the market, there are some potential cons to think about and some pros. So on the con side, we'll start with the bad news and end with the good news. On the con side, you need to think about whether you can get approved for financing while you're still carrying your current mortgage. So can your income support two mortgages so that you can actually get approved to go out and purchase that new home? If you can, do you actually want to carry two mortgages for a period of time? Because you don't know how long it's going to take to sell your home. So you just want to keep that in mind with your family's financial situation. Do you want to have two mortgages going on at the same time? The final thing, and this is something that surprises a lot of people, but it's really important to consider. If you're going out and looking for another home and say that you can't get approved for financing and you don't want to carry two mortgages, but you still think you'd like to purchase first, and this happens a lot, what you're going to have to do is write a contingent offer when you find your dream home. And what that means is that you're saying you're not going to move forward on purchasing that house until your house sells. If your house isn't even on the market, you got to look at it from the perspective of the seller of that house. That's not a very attractive offer to them because they're thinking, okay, this could be 3 months that I'm waiting to sell my house. It could be 6 months. It could be longer. And a lot of sellers don't want to tie up their home under a contract that might not go through. So the downside of that is that you may miss out on your dream house because of the fact that your offer won't be that attractive, unless if you can carry two mortgages and you can just move forward on both immediately.
A couple of pros for buying before selling are you're gonna know where you're going. And so there's no question mark in terms of when you sell your house, where am I gonna go? Am I gonna have to rent, stay with family in the meantime? And there's also no gap. So you can typically move right into that new house as you're selling that, as you're selling your existing house.
Right. Now on the flip side, if you decide, and this is probably the more common path that people take, if you decide to get your current house on the market first and try to sell that before you buy, there are still some pros and cons with that, although I would say this is the more popular of the two options. So on the downside, if you sell your house, it goes under contract and you're not sure where you're going to go next, you do have a shorter window. It might be 30 or 45, even up to 60 days usually, to find where you're going next. So there'll be a little bit of pressure to find the next place. Usually that's not a big deal, but it is something to consider that you're not gonna be able to look for 6 months for your house. You have to kind of find something quickly. There's also the potential that you could have a gap between closing on your current home and moving into your next. And then you need to think about, what are you gonna do with all of your stuff? Where are you gonna live? So are you gonna rent something? Are you gonna get a storage unit? What makes the most sense for your family? Sometimes you can close on your current house and on the new house in the same day, and it's not an issue, but there is that risk. The last thing is there's an unknown length of time, so you don't know how long it's going to take you to sell your current house. And there is the chance, if you know your dream house is already out there waiting for you and you're waiting for your house to sell before you make an offer, you might lose it. So that's just a little bit of a risk there as well.
Some pros for selling before buying are you're better able to negotiate the purchase. So you don't have to write a contingent offer on the sale of your home. You can potentially pay with cash if you have enough proceeds from your sale. But it gives you a little bit more flexibility when you're going to buy that new home. Mm-hmm. And of course, one of the biggest pros, unless you're paying cash, is that you will only have one mortgage at a time. And so some people don't realize how difficult it can be to carry two mortgages at once if you're not used to that based on your income. So a couple of things to keep in mind when you're thinking about buying and selling around the same time. So thank you so much, guys, and have a great day today, and we look forward to hearing from you.
Stay cool out there. Thanks.